Hello students, here we will start new topic of second chapter, reproduction in lower and higher animals. In last lecture,
seen
the structure of breast and accessory glands. In breast, there is a breast cancer occur, lump is occur, lump, knot or swelling is occur, which is present in breast or under arm. It is painless, but swelling is occurred on breast or overall, as well as redness, retraction of nipple, skin become thick, breast skin become thick, and discharge from the nipple. It is the symptoms of breast cancer. What is the diagnosis? By mammography, by sonography, as well as by MRI, blood test, we can diagnose the breast cancer. What is the treatment? There is a chemotherapy, radiotherapy, by surgery, removal of breast, and there are a number of treatment on the breast cancer. Then we will see the structure of ovary. In last lecture, we see the development of ovary. Ovary is a primary sex organ which is situated in the pelvic region and function produces OHA as well as hormones. Female ovary, there is a cyclic changes occurs in menstrual cycle. First menstrual cycle occurred at the age of 13, called as menarche. And last or stopping of menstrual cycle occur in the age of 45 to 55 years of woman, called as menopause. And in between these two, menarche to menopause, this is the 32 year period, is the reproductive period. In this period, every year near about maximum 416 eggs produced by female. Here we will see the histology or TS of mature female ovary. Ovary have two part, the external more granular compact part called as cortex. This is outermost part which is more compact and granular. It is cortex, and inner structure, this inner stroma is called as medulla. The stroma is nothing but the supply to ovary, blood vessels, lymph vessels, nerves, etc. And what is the cortex? In cortex, there is a number of developing follicles. Primordial follicle, primary, secondary, or graafian follicle, corpus luteum, etc. Number of developing stages of follicles are seen in cortex. These changes occur in menstrual cycle. These cyclic changes occur in this ovary, as well as changes occur in the oocyte. This follicle having this OHA, oocyte. This in oocyte, also changes occur through this menstrual cycle. This is the changes seen in the cortex. How it is possible? It is because of influence of gonadotropin hormone. The two type of hormone, FSH and LH. In female, there are two gonadotropin hormone secreted by pituitary, FSH and LH, which influence these changes. This FSH influence this development of primordial follicle into graafian follicle. This is influenced by this FSH hormone. Here, this primordial follicle, there are 2 to 6 primordial follicle develop into primary follicle. Primary follicle means follicular, cuboidal epithelial cells of follicle increases, and this stroma cells added to this follicle, this is called as theca. Theca is added to follicle and this is called as primary follicle. this primordial follicle, how it is converted into primary follicle. This cuboidal epithelial or cuboidal follicular cells become increases, their number become increases, and stroma cells added externally to this follicle, this tough covering, fibrous covering outside called as theca, and this is converted into primary follicle. This is called as primary follicle. Then it convert into secondary follicle. The inside this theca, there is a interna, theca externa, theca interna, and this green color follicular cell is the membrana granulosa. This green color layer is the membrana granulosa. This membrana granulosa cells become increases in secondary follicle, and this membrana granulosa cells secrete hormone estrogen, and this is called as secondary follicle. Primary follicle, primordial, number of cuboidal follicular cell increases, stroma cells added externally, theca, and it is called as primary follicle. Then primary follicle, because of FSH hormone, this follicular cells increases, this membrana granulosa inner layer is, its number is increases, and this membrana granulosa cells secrete estrogen hormone. And changes occur in this oocyte also. This oocyte is converted into primary to secondary oocyte. This is primary, then it is converted into secondary oocyte. This is called as secondary follicle. This forming follicle called as secondary follicle. Then this secondary follicle then develop into graafian, or it is also called as mature follicle. This graafian follicle also called as, this graafian follicle is also called as mature follicle. In this, there is outermost layer, this black color layer is the theca externa. Then red color layer is the theca interna, and this green color layer is the membrana granulosa. And this is fluid filled cavity antrum, and this is the oocyte. This membrana granulosa cells forms this discus prolegirus on which this oocyte situated, and this is fluid filled cavity called as antrum. This mature follicle formed by this secondary follicle, this is the maturation takes place and form the graafian follicle. Why it is graafian? This is discovered by scientist graafian, so it is graafian follicle. When it mature, it become pushed towards the thin layer of ovary. It is pressed over the thin layer of ovary, and blister is formed. Here, blister-like structure is formed. And on the 14th day, because of influence of this LH hormone, this graafian follicle become burst. On the 14th day, this mature graafian follicle become burst and releases OHA called as ovulation. Mature follicle on the 14th day or middle of menstrual cycle become burst or ruptured and releases OHA in the pelvic cavity called as ovulation. This cause the pains, mild pain or severe pain in the lower abdomen, and then remaining follicular cell form the structure called as corpus luteum. This is temporary endocrine structure. This remaining cell of follicular cells form this temporary endocrine structure called as corpus luteum. It secretes hormone called as progesterone. If the fertilization not takes place, this released OHA, which is then picked up by femur, then oviduct, and in the ampulla, it wait for 24 hours. And when there is no fertilization, this corpus luteum is wait for only 14 days, for 2 weeks, and then it degenerate into corpus albucans. This corpus luteum is then degenerate into corpus albucans. These changes occur in the cortex of ovary. Primordial follicle convert into primary, primary then secondary into graafian or mature follicle. Then on middle day of menstrual cycle, it bursts, rupture, releases OHA called as ovulation. Remaining cell of this follicle forms the temporary endocrine structure called as corpus luteum. It secretes progesterone. It waits for 2 weeks for fertilization of this OHA, but when there is no fertilization, it degenerates into corpus albucans. These are the changes occurred in the ovary or cortex during menstrual cycle. Then what is Graafian follicle? Here you do not understand by this small structure. Here we see the detailed structure of this mature follicle or Graafian follicle. This Graafian follicle, there is an outermost layer, this black layer, outermost fibrous layer, protective layer called as theca externa, which is non-cellular layer, which is fibrous protective layer called as theca externa. Inner to it is the theca interna. This theca interna is the cuboidal follicular cells. And this cuboidal follicular cells, this red color cuboidal follicular cells, they secrete hormone called as estrogen. As well as inner to it, there is a membrana, this green color layer called as membrana granulosa. This membrana granulosa line inner to theca interna. Theca externa, this black color, then red color cuboidal follicular cell, theca interna. And inner to it, this green color layer called as membrana granulosa. This membrana granulosa differentiate into two type. This hill of cell called as discus proligerus, on which this oocyte situated. On this hill of cell, this oocyte becomes situated, this hill called as discus proligerus. And this oocyte again encircled by this membrana granulosa cells called as corona radiata. Means membrana granulosa differentiate into two type of cell, discus proligerus and this outer covering to OHA or oocyte is the corona radiata. Then there is a fluid filled cavity called as antrum between membrana granulosa and oocyte. This cavity called as antrum, which is filled by liquor folliculi, the liquid called as liquor folliculi. And this is the secondary oocyte, this inner structure called as secondary oocyte, which is covered by this corona radiata or membrana granulosa cells and situated on the discus proligerus. This structure called as columnus oophorus. The oocyte, which is covered by membrana granulosa cells, situated on the cells of or hill of membrana granulosa cell called as discus proligerus. This structure, this whole structure called as columnus oophorus. This secondary oocyte, this secondary oocyte have a thin layer cells membrane called as vitelline membrane. Cell membrane of this egg or ovum. This ovum is ovulated by, this is the ovulated ovum after menstrual cycle. This ovum, separate structure of this ovum. This is the Graafian follicle, which is present in ovary. Then this is the Graafian follicle. Then this is the secondary oocyte. Here we see the secondary oocyte. Secondary oocyte have a cell membrane called as vitelline membrane. And this vitelline membrane secrete a non-cellular layer around it called as zona pellucida. This is called as zona pellucida. The two layer present around the oocyte, vitelline membrane and zona pellucida. And this membrana granulosa cells also cover this secondary oocyte. And after ovulation, this membrana granulosa cells stick here, stick to this ovum, attach to ovum and form the another third layer around this zona pellucida. This is the cellular layer formed around this zona pellucida. This is called as corona radiata. This layer is called as corona radiata. Means mature ovum have three layers. Here only two layers, vitelline membrane and zona pellucida. But after ovulation, it have three membranes. Cellular membrane outside to zona pellucida is the corona radiata. This is the structure of ovary or histology of ovary. Then we see the puberty or sexual maturity, how it is occurred in male and female. How it is occurred? Reproductive organ become functional, and this organ, sex organ or reproductive organ, this sex organ begins to produce gametes, means testis begins to produce sperm. Sperm is a male gamete. Means reproductive organ functional and it produces gametes. This condition called as puberty or sexual maturity. The onset of puberty in the age of 12 to 15 year of boy, onset of puberty is in between 12 to 15 year of boy. It is influenced by a hormone called as testosterone hormone or androgen, and it also influence the secondary sexual character in the males. It not attain the puberty, it also control secondary sexual characters in male, like mustaches, beard, means facial hair growth, axial hair growth, broadening of shoulder, aggressiveness, change in the voice, this enlargement of Adam's apple, sex behavior, all these controlled by this testosterone hormone. After this puberty, the male attain the puberty, after that it remains functional up to the death. It remains functional. It is continuous process in male. But in female, the puberty or sexual maturity is attained on the age of between 10 to 14. In between 10 to 14, first menstrual cycle called as menarche, and last menstrual cycle, which is occurred in the age of 45 to 55, between 45 to 55. This is called as menopause, last menstrual cycle. And in these two, menarche to menopause, there is a reproductive period. Only in this period, female can reproduce young one. After menopause, she can't produce offspring or she can't produce young one normally, naturally. This 32 years reproductive period is the 32 years. In this 32 years, there is in one year 13 menstrual cycles occur, means maximum one female produce near about 416 eggs in his reproductive period, and maximum child capacity is 12. And this is influenced by gonadotropin hormone in female, FSH and LH. Menarche, menopause, this is influenced or controlled by FSH and LH. Here, this is the sexual maturity in male and female. Thank you.